Hello, Calvin Jones here, Park Tool Company. In this Calvin's Corner video, we're going to focus on the narrow wide chainrings. These are becoming quite popular and trendy on mountain bikes and cyclocross bikes. The wide narrow chainrings are well named. Let's look at this picture and see that there is a narrow and a wide tooth on the left. These match up with the chain on the right. You'll see that the two outer plates are matching with the wide tooth, the two inner plates with the narrow tooth. It seems to be that wide tooth that locks and holds the chain as it comes around. So this chain ring is used only when there is a single front chain ring. No front derailleur is used. It is best used with the clutch style rear derailleurs. So let's get a better idea by some testing of how they work and when they work. Here we're going to do a test. We're going to apply a bouncy load to the chain, slapping back and forth, and that horrible load, the lateral side load. In a regular chain ring with no guide, it just seems to fall off very easily. This is why you would never want to run a normal chain ring without a front derailleur or protection of some type. Now, let's put on a narrow wide chain ring and let's run that same type of test again. So, a bouncy situation, impacting the chain, slapping around, going sideways, it really does tend to stay on pretty well. So in good circumstances, these chain rings do seem to do their job. However, there are circumstances that this chain ring will still fail. These are when it's very rough conditions, that's cyclocross and mountain biking, but combined with mud. So let's see a recent case where something occurred like a failure. Keep an eye on our rider as he transitions from dirt to pavement and watch the bounce of the chain. It dropped. Right there is the chain slap. It falls off. We can see him at the top of the screen now. Get off his bike. He is going to fix that. He's going to get back on and get going. When can this happen? Again, rough and bouncy conditions combined with mud. But the worst constituent of mud is actually clay. Now, I don't know if this was the case in the Czech Republic, but clay buildup tends to fill up the teeth. It raises the rollers. Let's have a look what happens with a chain ring that is packed with this clay. Here, we're applying the same type of load and we do get a failure. It's nothing different than we did before, but it does fail. A sideways view gives us the best action of what's really going on. Normally, at the 12 o'clock position, we would see that chain locked in place, but the mud is filling up between the pointed teeth, lifting that roller, and we can see some daylight there where it should be locked down. What happens? We get just the right bounce at just the wrong time, and over it can go. So, what would be best then? A guide, in addition to these special chain rings. This is much like a derailleur. It wraps around the chain, holds it in. So, you might ask yourself, why should I bother with the special rings? Why not just run a traditional chain ring, run a chain guide? That's probably going to save some money. Let's see what happens. Here we have the chain guide with traditional chain ring. It does a better job, but it does come off a complete failure. It's better than nothing, but still, you can't call it the best. So, if you want the most security, we really need to run a guide of some sort and a special designed ring. That can be good holding power. Here, it's not coming off. So, in conclusion, again, if you want the most secure, run with the guide and the narrow wide. suspenders, and a belt. Thank you.